Hey guys, it's Yuri here at Stankenda. Today we're going to go through small machine we have here. It's a small manual vase, 14 by 40 capacity. We start to wait to bring to Canada here for people who are going to use it for their hobby purposes mainly. For their garage, it's like 220 volt machine and it's a single phase, what's its most important here. Machine has 14 by 40 capacity. What we have here, let's start from the beginning and go through general characteristics of the machine, and then we'll do the real test. Machine comes with 3 drill chuck on default, 10 inch in diameter. You can swing 14 inches above the bed, but here you have a gap, which pretty extended. You can remove it, and now you have ability to swing 20 inch. Center distance on the machine is a 40 inch from the chuck to the tailstock. We have a headstock on this side and a spindle with 2-inch bore sitting on 2 taper roller bearings. Headstock has high and low range and 4 gears times high and low, which means we have 8 speed range from 70 RPM all the way to 2000 RPM. Down here we have a feed direction knob, which allows you to change direction of your feet or thread you cut. Here we have all your control buttons, which is pretty simple. Your power on, your coolant on and off, your jog button and emergency stop. Here we have full range feed box, which allows you to cut any type of threads pretty much. Even you can get 11.5 TPI threads. Machine has Imperial execution, which means it has Imperial lead screw and Imperial crosswise screw, which allows you to cut Imperial threads by disengaging your half nut and using the thread dial right here. So if you cut your thread, you disconnect your half nut, come back, pick up your thread again using this thread dial. In same time, you can cut the metric threads and all other module threads and woodworth thread, but this way you need to keep your half nut engaged. Inside the spindle we have Morse 5 taper. Here we have quick change, tool post, compound, digital readout for both axes, tailstock, single range with Morse 4 taper in here. Machine comes on default with steady rest and the follow rest. In the carriage area we have a lead screw cover on both sides, on the left and on the right. We have half nut engagement lever and we have a cross and longitudinal feed engagement lever here. On this side we have forward and reverse handle. Down below we have nice chip tray, which is easy to remove for cleaning the chips when you're all done. So down here we have a foot brake, which can be used in emergency situation or to quick stop the chuck. On the left side on the support we have a built-in toolbox with three drawers. On the roller guides, on the right-hand side, we have a door which allows you to get access to your coolant tank and coolant pump here. By default, we have machine come with Sino digital readout system, which 2 axes connected to it, like cross axis and longitudinal one, and able to work in Imperial, in this case, or in metric system. You just click the button and Imperial, you switch to metric and switch to Imperial again. This digital readout system also able to do some simple calculations. We have a manual come with it. You can go through it, but otherwise it's pretty accurate and we can use it for general machining. So now once we went through general machine characteristic, let's do the real test. What we're gonna do here, we'll try to cut about 3/8 of the diameter, so about 180 tau from diameter at feed of about 7 inches per revolution. So let's see how it's gonna work. So we're gonna set up the spindle RPM at 460, which is already there. So, and basically we start the spindle. So what we're doing here, we're gonna touch the piece. So we reset our point to zero. and we're going. So it's about 200 tau. So let's see what happens. So now, to stop the machine, we can use a couple of ways. We can simply move the handle to the neutral and machine slowly stop now in same time. If something happens or you want to stop it immediately, you can always push the foot brake and spindle stops immediately. Now, machine has on default 2 horsepower motor, which is capable to be handled by normal household 220-volt circuit. It's not going to take too much amperage. I would say on average you should be able to find if you have 15 amp service. Same thing, we'll test reverse. We go on reverse. We can stop it easily. So let's check the low gear here. So we're shifting to the low range. Here we go. And basically right now we have a slowest RPM on the, how much machine can handle. Again, you open the chuck guard, machine automatically stop. You would have to restart it again. And again, you can use your foot brake to stop the machine. Okay, so let's try to check some speeds on the machine. So let's start from the low range. Let's go to 70 RPM, which is the lowest range here. So basically here is our lowest speed. Now on this point, if something happens about what we previously mentioned for safety, say for example this door get open, machine is automatically stop. In order to reset again, you need to move the handle up. Let's go to the next speed. 115. Forward, again, brake, stop. 300 right here. 100, stop, reverse. And let's move to the high range. So the lowest speed on the high range is 460. It's probably gonna be one of the most common speeds everybody gonna use, like 460, 700 for small pieces. So, and let's go to the higher ranges, let's see what happens here. So, 755. So, machine picking up speed pretty nice, pretty quick. Okay. Brake. Let's go to 1255. Here is our 2000 RPM, and let's try to see how quick we can stop the machine with foot brake in emergency scenario. So, probably within a second we stop the spindle. Pretty good. Now guys, I want to warn you about something here. Like, 2000 RPM speed is pretty thirsty power-wise for acceleration purposes. So, when you use your machine at your place, at your garage or at home, at your small shop, you should make sure you're wiring properly, because during the acceleration it might take about 40 amps of power to speed up this spindle to this 2000 RPM range. So please make sure when you connect machine to power you have big enough cable and your services properly installed, so it's not kicking out the power on the machine during acceleration. Otherwise, if everything is good, you will see what's happening here. It's picking up the speed, no problem. And when we was using that small cable at first time when we start the machine, it was kicking out power and machine wasn't able to reach this 2000 RPM, it was just dying basically. It was able to get 1200 RPM, but 2000, it's basically like almost twice speed, not twice, but like 60% more. Machine wasn't able to do it at that point of time. So now let's talk a little bit about carriage control for the feet and for speed. So basically, what we have here, we have a half nut handle. To control the half nut, down we engage it, and up is disengage. On the right hand side here, we have a handle to control the cross feet and longitudinal feet. So now to put machine in the cross mode, we need to move the handle to the right, and during the spindle rotation, we just move it down basically. So now that cross handle start to go that way, and in same time, if we want to engage longitudinal, we disconnect it, move it out, and move it up. So this way, our carriage going, in this case, to the left. So now, in same time, inside the apron, as normal, there is an interlock which not allows you to engage your half nut. So in this time, it's not engaging because you have your longitudinal fin engaged. Now you disconnect it and able to connect your half nut. In same time, if you want to change direction, for example, going to the right and outwards this way, we need to move this handle this way, and your lead screw and feed rod change rotation, and the carriage will go to the right or towards yourself. Let's see how it works in real life. So we start the machine, and right now we on longitudinal mode. We move the handle up, and carriage start to go to the right. We want to change direction of it. We stop the machine, go to this handle, change the direction here. Don't change nothing here. And now it's going to the left. So the same situation gonna happens when we try to use it for cross slide. So we disengage it, move it to the right, down. Now we're facing the piece outwards. In same time, we need to change the direction. Stop the machine, move the handle to the right, forward, and now we're going opposite direction. Disconnect. Now let's try to engage a longitudinal lead screw. So in order to do so, we need to engage our lead screw and see what happens. Basically, lead screw is always running. You just cannot see, so it's turning, but it's always turning during the feed rod turning. We would need to set up our pitch and then basically start to cut the thread. Let's see how it works. So let's go to the low range first. So we're not speeding up the carriage too much. So on the lowest range here, basically we just engage in the handle. And now we have a thread cutting cycle basically to the right, which is basically left thread. We want to change direction here. We're going handle to the left, and now we're going to cut the right hand side thread. So the handle going to the left, and we're cutting our thread. Our dial indicator right now does not move, because it's connected to the lead screw. So, but as soon as we disconnect the half nut, thread dial start to rotate. And basically when you finish your cut, finish your pass, you can disconnect your half nut, go back to your position and wait until you catch in the same number here, say for example, number 7, and you engage half nut in that spot. Now it's not turning, and you're picking up exactly same pitch as you was cutting before, but again, this one only apply for imperial threads, not for metric. For metric, you always should keep this handle engaged, and when you're cutting it, for example, right now, what you need to do, you need to stop your spindle, give brake or something, and back up your feet, and do reverse. Now machine going backwards to the start point, you reach your start point, you stop the machine, you come back to your point, go forward. As simple as that. Now, regarding the compound, compound is pretty standard. In order to cut the tapers, we just need to loosen a couple bolts here on the front, one bolt and on the back, and it allows you to spin the compound to the angle you want. You have a scale here going 45 degrees each way. So now let's talk about some safety features of this machine. So first of all, we have chuck guard, which allows machine to stop when you have it open or if you open it accidentally. You have your chip guard, you have your lead screw cover on both sides. Also, you have a foot brake, which you can press to stop the machine. And on the left-hand side here, we have a safety switch, which not allows you to run the machine if these doors stay open, so nothing can get in between those gears or get into the belt area. Tailstock here. We have dials on the tailstock showing us metric and imperial here, so we can use it in both systems. Now the quill extends all the way. Let's see how much it's gonna be. 4 inches out, so 100 millimeter, 4 inches out. And you have a slot here to extract the tapers which are sitting in that quill. Now here we have a quill lock. For sure, which not allows you to, which locks the quill in place, and at the same time, here we have tailstock lock. So moving up, and tailstock stay in the position, get locked. On this side here, we also have nice feature to control the feed force. Right here, we have 4 holes. Inside those holes, there is 4 set screws, springs, and bolts. And what is it for? Basically, when our feed is exceeding some power, some certain level, this clutch starts to slip, and you can adjust it to certain level of safety. We always keep this machine in stock. We price it very aggressively, so please get back to our website, which is stencanada.com, to find actual prices and sales happening at that point of time. And we ship all the way in Canada and across North America. Thank you and have a good one.